Hello everyone. CBSE conducted retest of Class 12th Economics paper today. As we know, that paper was leaked on March 23rd. Now, firstly, tell me, how did the paper go? Well, I hope all of you have attempted the paper well and will score good marks, as paper was easier than the previous one, which was held on March 26th. Let's analyze today's paper. Starting with question paper design, the design was exactly same as per CBSE blueprint. That is, in the paper, there were 1 marker, 3 marker, 4 marker, and 6 marker questions, 8 questions of 1 mark, 4 questions of 3 marks, 6 questions of 4 marks, and 6 questions of 6 marks. Overall, in the paper, there were 24 questions. There was also internal choice in questions of 3 marks, 4 marks, and 6 marks in both sections A and B. Now, let's talk about marks distribution. Starting with microeconomics, yes, we can say that the marks distribution was exactly same as given in the blueprint. Chapter 1 accounted for 4 marks. Chapter 2 accounted for 13 marks. Chapter 3 also accounted for 13 marks. And chapter 4 of 10 marks. Now, coming to macroeconomics, yes, here also no variations seen. Chapter 5 accounted for 10 marks. Chapter 6 accounted for 6 marks. Chapter 7 accounted for 12 marks. Chapter 8 accounted for 6 marks. And chapter 9 accounted for 6 marks. Overall, 80 marks paper. Now, talking about difficulty level students, starting with microeconomics, we can say that 85% of the paper was easy. There were direct and straightforward questions in the paper. 5% of the paper was average, and we can say that 10% of the paper was difficult. Now, coming to macroeconomics, 70% of the paper was easy and 30% of the paper was average. There were no difficult questions in macroeconomics. Now let's talk about the proportion of numericals. So in today's exam, 86% of the paper was theory based and 14% of the paper was numerical based. Now if we compare today's paper with the paper conducted on 26 March, we can see that numerical portion has been reduced from 18 marks to 11 marks. With this, now let's solve the numericals. So we will be solving numericals of macroeconomics because there were no numericals in microeconomics. So the first question, as you can see, is of 1 mark, in which legal reserve ratio is given as 20%. And you were asked to calculate money multiplier. The question is very simple. We know the formula of money multiplier. It is 1 upon legal reserve ratio. Just put the value in the formula. So it becomes 1 upon 20%. Now solving it, we get money multiplier as 5. Simple question. If you have solved it correctly, you will be getting 1 mark. Coming to the second question. In the second question, the value of average propensity to consume is given as 0.75, and the value of average propensity to save needs to be calculated. Students, we know that the sum of average propensity to consume and average propensity to save is 1. Now we need to put the value in the formula. Average propensity to consume is 0.75. Average propensity to save is to be calculated. So just simple calculation. Average propensity to save is 1 minus 0.75, which is 0.25. Now coming to the next question. In this question, we are given with the consumption function. Consumption function is 100 plus 0.6y. This question is of 3 marks and this question is very simple. The first part asks you to calculate the value of MPC and MPS. And the second part, you need to calculate the saving function. So for the first part, students, we know that the summation of marginal propensity to consume and marginal propensity to save is 1. So put the value in the formula. We know that consumption function, in the consumption function, 100 is autonomous consumption, 0.6 is nothing but marginal propensity to consume. So we get marginal propensity to consume as 0.6. Now we can easily calculate MPS, which is 1 minus MPC, that is 0.4. Now the second question is asking you to write the saving function. We know the formula of saving function. It is S equal to minus S bar, which is autonomous saving, which is equal to autonomous consumption, plus MPS Y. Y is income. Now, we know autonomous consumption, which is 100. So just put the value of S bar as 100, because we know that S bar is equal to C bar. So your saving function becomes minus 100 plus 0.4 Y, because we have calculated MPS as 0.4. This is the simplest question which you can get for 3 marks. If you have solved in this manner, you will get 3 on 3. Coming to next question, students. So this is the numerical question on national income. Very simple question. And this question is distributed in 2 parts, 3 plus 3. And in the question, you are given with all the values. Now, if you see the question, we can see that this is the question based on expenditure method, because all the variables of expenditure method are given. Students, we need to calculate GDP at MP and national income. So we know that GDP at MP, the formula to calculate GDP at MP is private final consumption expenditure, which is C, government final consumption expenditure, which is G, gross domestic capital formation, which is I, and net exports, which is X minus M. Now we are given with all these variables. Put the values in the formula. Private final consumption expenditure, 3,500. Government final consumption expenditure, 4,000. Gross domestic capital formation, 1,100. And net exports, 500. Now adding this, we get GDP at MP as 9,100. So if you have done this correctly, you will get 3 marks. Now coming to the second part, you need to calculate national income. We know that we can calculate national income from GDP at MP. We need to subtract consumption of fixed capital so that we can change gross to net. We will add net factor income from abroad, because we need to change from domestic to national. And we need to convert market price into factor cost. So we would be subtracting net indirect taxes. So it becomes 9,100 minus 120, which is consumption of fixed capital, plus 100, which is net factor income from abroad, which is given to us, minus net indirect taxes, which is 300. So we won't be considering subsidies, because net indirect taxes are given to us. Now putting the values in the formula, we get national income as 8,780. So students, this was a simple question. You just need to calculate GDP at MP and national income. In a nutshell, we can say that the paper was easy and straightforward. And I hope that all of you will score good marks in the examination. All the best for your results.